Hello and welcome to Morningstar. I'm Emma Wall and I'm joined today by James Montier, Head of Asset Allocation for GMO. Hello, James.
Hi.
So I've just heard your really interesting talk on contrarian investing, and you told us an anecdote, which is apparently contrarian investing causes you physical pain.
Yeah, there's a great brain study by Eisenberger and Lieberman, and they set up a computer game where they managed to simulate social exclusion. So you had three players playing, except two of them were a computer. And at one point, they dropped playing with the one person who's involved. And they were scanning people's brains when they were doing this. And what they found was that the parts of the brain that respond to that exclusion, that being ostracized, were exactly the same parts of the brain that effectively light up when you feel real physical pain. So being a contrarian, following a value-based approach is, in essence, like having your arm broken on a really regular basis.
Now, we all know it's hard. You know, we like to have a sheep, a herd mentality. We don't like to stick out from the crowd. But that's taking it, you know, illustrating how extremely difficult it is. So how do we overcome that difficulty in order to be successful investors?
I think that's the real challenge, and it requires a couple of different things. I think it requires an institutional framework that supports it, because it isn't just about human behavior. It's the combination of our behavior plus institutional impediments. And therefore, if you can remove the institutional impediments, then you can worry about the behavior. From a behavior point of view, I think there are a number of ways you can really seek to turn your behavioral shortcomings into advantages. Danny Kahneman has a wonderful expression, which is, if you cannot de-bias, re-bias. And people think it's very easy to stop behavioral problems. It's not. They are a byproduct of the way the brain works. So they're ingrained. So rather than try and stop them, the better way of dealing with them is to turn them to your advantage. So I think a really useful thing for a contrarian to have is a valuation framework, because that forces you to behave at a certain point in time. So let's say 2007, if you're using a valuation-based framework, you looked at the world and it looked hideously expensive. There was just no opportunity. Why would you want to invest in that world? You should have been sitting in a lot of cash and dry powder. Conversely, by 2009, the opportunity set was looking very rich. Everything was really cheap. And so we were very excited as investors. The advantage of having that framework is it's a first step. It forces you to say, well, these things are cheap. Why aren't I buying them? The reason you're not buying them, of course, and the reason they got cheap is because every newspaper is full of stories saying the world could end tomorrow. And it seems perfectly plausible that it could. But ultimately, you have to say, well, I'm going to bet the percentages. I'm going to go with the forecast framework we have, which says these things are cheap.
Because whenever an asset class or even a particular fund has a fantastic year, of course, it's the following year where you see incredible inflows into that asset class or individual fund. So what you're saying then is, actually, we need to remove the emotion from investing.
Absolutely.
We need to all become robos.
Yeah, exactly. And it's really hard to do. So John Templeton used to do all of his work on what he called cold days, when there wasn't anything happening in the market. He'd do his analysis and say, okay, I think this stock is worth X. Because he knew on a hot day, when things were falling apart in the market, he wouldn't have the discipline to do that. And I think that's another really good kind of pre-commitment strategy. Do your work when you're not feeling emotional, so that when you are, it doesn't matter, because you've already done the work and you've got it there. And you say, well, I think intrinsic value is this. The only thing that has changed is price. Therefore, I should be reacting to this.
James, thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
This is Emma Wall for Morningstar. Thank you for watching.